Hello family, this is Gamers Forum back with another Clash of Kings video. So guys, today is building event in the Kingdom vs Kingdom week, and now in this video I'm going to tell you the tips that how you can open all the 9 chests in the Kingdom vs Kingdom building event. Before starting the video, let me show you one thing. That in the one of my previous list of videos, there is a video on Archangel Wings. In that video I have mentioned how you can hit level 30 Neon Beast without using T10, T9 or any other troops except level 1. So many people in the comment section show that this thing is not working on. Guys, in that case you must clear your cache, means your message cache, and afterwards then try on, because I have just recently hit one of the level 30 Neon Beast and I am having a report here, and you can see I got 2 of the Angel Wings and the damage to the level 30 Neon Beast is 0.1%. My wounded count is 54,000, and this is all because of level 1 troop. So guys, it is a proof that the thing is really working on. I'm getting around 3 to 4 wings daily, but in some cases I'm getting at most 1 wings only. So it's not confirmed, it's a random amount of wings, but mostly on hitting level 30 Neon I'm getting the maximum count of wings. So let's start the video, but before starting the video let me tell you guys, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe it on. All the subscribers are showing a very much positive response to my channel. Thank you all, you are provoking me to do much more hard work for you guys so that everyone can grow together. Please don't forget to press the bell icon and don't forget to hit the like button if you find the video information useful. So guys, let's start the video. First, before starting the video, let's start the basic, that what things you need to open all the 9 chests. Let's start with the research. The science research that is needed for getting the maximum points in Kingdom vs Kingdom event week is the strongest kingdom preparation research. As you can see, this is the research here. I have completed 90%. This, the strongest kingdom preparation research, is fully focused on the point purpose. It increases the massive amount of point that is being added to your personal point list after each action in that particular event day. So what you need to do is just complete this inspiration construction to the max level of 10. It will increase your points of building by 200% on each action. Apart from this, there is one more research that you have to do on, is the arms dealer. It also increases your point value by 200% on each action in the particular day. So this is the basic research that you have to do. Without this research you can't attain or achieve all the 9 chests. So guys, please start working on the strongest kingdom preparation research and do it on, so that you all will get the benefit of that. One more thing that this strongest kingdom preparation research will give you is the twice the rewards. Yes, if you research this one, then you will get twice research personal point rewards. Means if you are getting at the stage 1 or at the first box, if you are getting so the benefit of this twice reward procedure or research in this strongest kingdom preparation is that if you are getting 1000 gold on opening the chest reward chest 3 of personal point, then you will get twice the rewards, mean you are going to get 2000 of gold in the action of twice reward section in this strongest kingdom preparation research. So guys, please hurry up and research, complete this research 100%, because this research is very much beneficial. It substitute you, it gives you opportunity to gain maximum points in the kingdom versus kingdom weak in all the action, whether it is monster killing, whether it is gathering, whether it is researching, whether it is troops training or building. In all actions, it is going to give you point bonus. Apart from this, it also gives you point bonus in the kingdom versus kingdom battle week also. So guys, this is about the research. Apart from this, the equipment, let's come to the equipment set that I want that each and every of you should have. Guys, the equipment set now I am going to tell you is just because this equipment set will decrease the amount of prestige badges consumption on upgrading your prestige level of buildings. So guys, I want that each and every one of you should have at least two set of this equipment. The equipment set is the royal set. I want that each and every one of you should have this set. Not even one set, you should have all the two set, one for your main lord and one for your main hero. If you equip this set on both of your lord and hero, I'm not talking about the gold set, just you need green set, okay, two full set of green royal set. Okay, what's the benefit that this set is going to give you? It will severely decrease the amount of prestige badges needed for the upgrade, because if you want to open all the 9 chests, then you have to upgrade your buildings to the prestige level at most as you can. So guys, this is about the equipment set. So I want that each and every one of you should have two full complete set of royal, one for lord and one for your main hero. And for second hero, you can place any of the set that may be supporting the building speed, that's none of use. So next, what the thing that you have to do is just activate level 3 Light of Glory in the Wonder Building. Apart from this, just on activate Prosperous Era, which is 4th order dragon word. Okay, it also increases building speed by 5%. Next, you need to activate your Black Dragon with the building skill. As you can see, I am having building speed of plus 25% in the Black Dragon. I have upgraded this skill to the max level. Some of the special skills that I have added in my Black Dragon is, first is building speed, second one is training speed by 15%, third one is resource speed by 15%. So guys, each and every of you should also do the same thing with the Black Dragon. Equip all the three speed ups in the Black Dragon. It is really going to help you out in various events. So this is about the equipment set, the things that you have to activate before starting up the building. And now let's start that what you have to do. Let me first show you what I have got today on the Strongest Kingdom event. So as you can see, I have opened all the 9 chests and I have done the same thing as I am telling you guys in this video. And all the 9 chests, I have achieved an amount of 22k of gold, means 22,000 of gold I have got from this event today on opening all the 9 chests, because 2x reward research is being completed by me, so I get twice the reward in each action of the personal points. So this is the benefit that I have got. And now let me tell you that how I opened all the 9 chests. What I have done yesterday, a day before the building event is going to start, just on demolish all the farms, all the iron farms, all the wood farm, all the food and all the mithril. Remove each and every of the farm from your castle, demolish it on, and maybe the count will be around 14 to 15 if you demolish all of them. Okay, the last night on the gathering event, I demolished all the of my 15 farms, whether it is of iron, wood, metal, food, I demolished all of them. And after it, when the building event start, I just activated a scorecard of 100% and start upgrading my all the farms to the max level of P5. I have activated 100% scorecard because I just want that the minimum efforts I want to show, I have extra of the scorecards. That's why I have that. No, it's not needed that you should activate the 100% scorecard, because if you don't activate the 100% scorecard, all you have to do is just on, you have to build all the 15 farms. Apart from this, just you have to complete two or three buildings of your hospital or any or the training. Okay, you can demolish the military tent or the hospital as for the advance, so that you can get points from that, because they give extra points as compared to the farms and other buildings. So guys, this is the thing that you have to do on, okay, one night before the event starts, just on demolish all the farms in your castle. Okay, if you don't want to use any of the boost means scorecard, then also demolish 2 to 3 of numbers of hospital or military tent. And when the event start on, just on start upgrading on the buildings to the maximum level. And many of the people are thinking that it consumes a lot of resources, but seriously guys, if you are equipping royal set on your lord, on your hero, main hero and lord, then a minimum amount of upgrading these buildings, you are going to spend around 100 maximum of 100k of wood on upgrading your buildings to max P5. Okay guys, and one more benefit that you are getting from the two sets of royal is that for upgrading to the max level of P5, the amount of prestige badges needed in this action is zero. Yes guys, if you equip the royal set to your main hero and your lord, then the amount of prestige badges needed to upgrade your farm, mithril, iron mine, food mine, all of these buildings to max P5, the amount of consumed prestige badges will be zero. So guys, this is very much beneficial. That's why I have told you to you that you should have at least two sets of green royal sets. So guys, please try to get on, because it is quite more beneficial, as we all know that it's not that easy to get the prestige badges. That's why this trick is going to help you out. So guys, do it on. As you can see, I have upgraded all my mines to max P5. Apart from this, I have upgraded my all the hospitals, military tents and every other buildings which are giving me which are consuming zero of my prestige badges, I have upgraded all of them to the max level. As you can see, hospital at prestige up to prestige level 2, or military tent at most at level P2, it don't consume any of the prestige badges if you are having the royal set for both of for your lord and hero. So the main thing is that all you have to do is just complete the strongest kingdom preparation research, have two sets of royal, and demolish all your mines, some of your hospital and military tents, and just start the researching on the research day. And in result, you will get all the 9 chests as I have it. Guys, I don't have done any other thing apart from this, and you can see that I have got all the 9 chests in this event. This thing that I have mentioned on that building food mine and all these mines to the max P5, it is a time consuming process. Yes, it is somewhat sometimes boring a lot, because I too get bored in these actions when I used to do. In today morning, it consumes around 1.5 hour for me to do all this process of upgrading all my buildings to max level P5. So it consumed 1.5 hours, so I too got bored in this action. But the result of 22k gold, lot of prestige badges, research stones, lord XPs and all these things just really make me happy when I used to see all these things in my item list. So guys, this is very much beneficial. I want that each and every one of you should at least try up this thing to open all the 9 chests, and you will really going to get a lot of benefit from this. So guys, this is about today's video. I hope you all guys really like the video, and you all have get the information that I want you to get on from this video. So guys, if you really get the information of this video that I have mentioned in it, then please guys try it on. The buff that you are getting from all the 9 chests is really going to help you a lot. So do the same thing as I have mentioned on, because this thing will help you a lot in case of resources consumption, prestige badges needed for upgrades. In every proportion, it is going to help you all. So guys, please implement the things in the similar way I have mentioned on, and this thing is really going to help on. So this is about today's video. Please comment below that what do you feel about this video? Do you really like it or not? Are you going to try it on not? Please comment below and let me know that what do you think, that you will attain all the 9 chests from this thing or not. Apart from this, if you are new here, please subscribe the channel, hit the like button if you find the video information useful, and don't forget to press the bell icon for the latest update. Gamer Forum will keep you guys updated with all the latest news and events regarding the Kingdom vs Kingdom week and all the latest update implemented by the Clash of Kings server. So guys, at last, the same thing I want to tell: keep growing with Gamers Forum. Thank you guys.